It's used for a midweek Eucharist. It is used for our liturgy of the word for children on Sunday mornings. It is sometimes used for funerals. It is sometimes used as a wedding chapel. And it has a varied history. One of the pieces of history of Christ Church Cathedral is that if you were a person of color and you came to Christ Church Cathedral before the mid-1940s, the first thing you were asked or told if you came in to try to come into worship on Sunday morning is, oh, wouldn't you be more comfortable over at All Saints, which is the historically black church in St. Louis, when really the comfort had nothing to do with the people, it had to do with the white people who were the worshiping congregation here. But if you insisted on coming in and worshiping at Christ Church Cathedral, this is where you were taken in, was into Bofinger Chapel. Because until the cathedral nave was integrated in the mid-1940s, if you were a person of color, this was the only part of the cathedral that you were allowed in. And that's a part of our history, and it's important to remember those pieces of our history, and that they are in the not-too-distant past, and to continue to look at what are the ways that we still today treat some of God's children as less than. Another piece of Bofinger Chapel is this really is the place where we are reminded of the communion of saints. We have a unique columbarium here, and our columbarium is in the floor. And we have people who for decades have been inurned in the floor of Christ Church Cathedral. And there are some amazing saints of God here. There are bishops and presiding bishops and captains of industry and wonderful, faithful people whose names have been lost to history and even to their families, except for their presence here. We had a wonderful Eagle Scout a couple years ago do a research project for his Eagle Project and went back into records over at Central Library and other places and found out which of the people who are buried here had been veterans of the U.S. Armed Forces, and then made little flags and stands so that on Veterans Day and Memorial Day now, we put the chairs to the side and we set up little flags on the stones of all those who served in our armed forces. And so in one room we have our youngest Christians, those who are just learning the faith. And they are literally learning it on top of the remains of those who have gone before. And it's a reminder to us that we all stand on others' shoulders and that we are never following Jesus by ourselves. We always follow Jesus, not just in community with those who are here now, but in the language of the Sursum Corda, with saints, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven. Together we all sing this song.